Okay. In the last class, we talked about that mass transfer and little bit about that mode of mass transfer. Okay. After mode of mass transfer, in the mode of mass transfer, we discuss about ET diffusion, your molecular diffusion, convection, and your phase change mass transfer. Okay. Okay. After that, we also discuss about the film theory. Correct. Film theory means there will be small gas liquid film if it is aqueous, or this particular portion is liquid, then here will be aqueous film will be there, AF, and here will be liquid film will be there, L, liquid film, LF. Okay, this thing we have discussed, and we also seen that how the mass transfer will occur at the interface. Okay, according to the film theory, we also discussed that here at this particular region, diffusion occur around that film, like in gas film, or you can say the aqueous film, aqueous film, or in liquid film, whatever. Okay, means at the interface there will be only diffusion, and here will be your mixing, or you can say turbulence will be there. So turbulence will be created by mixing. Okay, we have also seen how that the profile, if you'll segregate in four pattern, we have also seen this thing, like here will be your turbulence, here will be your diffusion at the interface, and here will be your diffusion, and here will be turbulence. This thing we have discussed to interrelate our mass transfer into your bioreactor. Okay, this physical interpretation comes from where? When you are sparging any kind of oxygen gas into liquid medium, and here we have shown that how the diffusion or mass transfer will occur from oxygen rich bubble to your liquid medium. Okay, so this thing we have discussed, and we have also seen how the boundary condition and all properties it is changing. Okay, after that we also talk about like little bit about that the convection and the diffusion, what is the difference between convection and that the diffusion. We also seen that if any object which is moving, like same example, let me repeat, because this thing it is applicable when you want to differentiate between convection and your diffusion. Okay, when any body which is moving with respect to any frame, then there will be a relative velocity. Okay, there is a two object, there is two object, when it is moving there will be the relative velocity, and you will claim here that there will be no convection term, means only the diffusion will be there. But if anything which is moving, there will be your convection and that the diffusion. This thing we have discussed. Okay, after that, this thing we have discussed, we have also seen that how we can derive the formula and how can correlate with your that heat transfer as well. This thing we have also seen, steady state diffusion through a plane membrane, and similarly for cylinder, and similarly for sphere. Okay, this thing we have finished. Okay, today we will discuss about steady state equimolar counter diffusion. This thing we will discuss. Okay, first of all, we will have to check why we are reading this kind of interpretation, like a steady state equimolar counter diffusion or steady state co-current diffusion, and what are the significance of that diffusion term. If you have one chamber, this is your one chamber, and this is your another chamber, this is your partition, any kind of membrane, and here you have compound A, and here it is your compound B, and you are claiming that diffusion will occur from this direction to this direction, because A have the higher concentration at this particular is in this chamber, and here the B will have the higher concentration in this chamber. when you will remove this barrier, what will happen? Diffusion will occur from this direction to this direction. Now have a look at the physical significance of that. The diffusion will occur from this position to this position, and B will diffuse from this position to this position, correct? Then both are counter diffusion, correct? We have read in heat transfer, similarly heat transfer, counter diffusion and concurrent flow or counter current flow. If the fluid, when it is entering at this direction and it is leaving from this direction, and you are injecting your sulfide fluid in this direction, now you can see the flow pattern will be like that only. Okay, so this kind of pattern called as the co-current, co-current in same direction, correct? We have also seen one example, like this is your cell. If you have, this is tube, this is your tube. And we have also seen when the liquid will enter from this direction to this direction, hot liquid or cold liquid, whatever. And here, when the fluid will enter in this direction, you will find that here will be your counter flow, opposite to the direction of the flow. Okay? The sulfide fluid will enter from this position and it will go in this direction. Means here you will find counter diffusion. Okay? And here you are claiming that here will be counter heat transfer will occur, and here co heat transfer will occur. Okay, means both are parallel to each other. Okay, after this, similar kind of pattern you will find here also, like A will diffuse from higher concentration to the lower concentration, and B will diffuse from higher concentration to lower concentration. Okay, so to approach this kind of problem, you have to determine how the heat, how the mass flux, or you can say the mass transfer happening from one chamber to the another chamber. How you will determine? You have to determine the rate of mass transfer. Okay, how you will approach? Now this thing we have discussed, that how you will derive this equation. This is nothing but this is first law of diffusion. Okay, Na. It is your mass flux, okay, this particular, and here we have converted into pressure, not in term of concentration, we have converted into pressure. Okay, now you can see Na is equal to Ma by A. We want to determine how the diffusion will takes place from this direction to this direction, when A will diffuse from here to here. Okay, this is your area is equal to minus dAb A divided by G, universal gas constant, T temperature, delta P by delta X. Okay, same you have to write for B also. Okay, but area will be same, definitely area will be same. Okay, because you are assuming this is the chamber where the diffusion will take place, this is the whole chamber area. Okay, now to approach this kind of problem, what you have to do, you have to assume that how much is the total pressure inside your reaction mixture. Okay, then you have to add all the partial pressure where the diffusion will occur, like A plus and B. Okay, you have to add both. What I am saying means, whenever you are dealing with like diffusion from one position to another position, you have to keep in mind that you are claiming at that particular system will be in equilibrium when diffusion will be in equilibrium. What does that mean? If you have one chamber, two chambers, chamber A, chamber B. Okay, when you will remove this thing after half an hour or after 1 hour, what will happen? A compound and B compound will be well mixed. Okay, well mixed if you will remove this barrier. Okay, so same thing means you are claiming here after some time P, the partial pressure, total pressure is equal to, it will be the sum of partial pressure of both compound A and B. Okay, then how the diffusion will take place? Now you can see it will be like that, the higher concentration to the lower concentration, and B will diffuse in this direction from higher to lower. But if you will, in some standard book also, they are mentioning like curve shape structure. Okay, this is also correct. Okay, like curve shape. Okay, but this is very correct. Why we have written heat transfer around the surface? Around the surface, there is a curve type of shape of heat transfer as well. Whenever that diffuse, whenever the heat transfer will occur from this surface, higher temperature to lower temperature, okay, flow direction like that. Okay, temperature T1 is higher and T2 is lower here, lower. Then you will got little bit at due to the film, you will get this kind of a structure. Means there will be little bit curve shape. We have discussed in heat transfer. Okay, and similarly for that also you will get this kind of pattern. This kind of pattern. Okay, that's why if someone it is saying you have to draw your heat transfer or diffusion profile only for the surface, only for you can say the film, then what you have to do, you have to make little bit curve type of shape of structure. Okay, if you read any kind of standard book like Duron is there, which is fully based on bio processing, then you will find this kind of curve. Both are correct. Okay, both are correct. Now how you will approach, as I already told, you have to add both pressure, like as per Dalton's law, partial pressure you have to add, it will be the sum of the total pressure will be equal to the sum of all the partial pressure which will be present into your reaction system. Okay, then P is equal to PA plus PB. Take the differentiation. Why you are doing this? Because you need this expression. You want to determine del PA by del X, del PB by del X. To determine this particular term, what you have to do, you have to rearrange your physical properties to get this values. How much will be the how much will be the mass flux, and or you can say the how much will be your rate of mass transfer. Okay. Now you have to take the differentiation, and then what you have to assume, the total pressure of the system remain constant under a steady state condition. Okay, as we discussed that after a particular time, what will happen? A and B will be well mixed each and everywhere. It will be well mixed. Then what will happen when it will become completely mixed in this particular system? So at a particular steady state condition, means you are assuming no property it is changing with respect to time, then delta P by delta X approaches to zero. Okay, delta P by delta X will approach to zero, and what will happen whenever you will put zero, this will be your final expression, like del PA by del X is equal to minus del PB by del X. Okay, then what you have to do, you have to put this expression in this particular reaction system, then what you will get, now you can see here, now under the steady state condition, total molar flux relative to the stationary condition must be zero. Okay, Na plus Nb is equal to zero. Na is equal to minus Nb. Okay, you have got this thing. But here, if you will check each and every property, it is little bit similar. Like this property means A will be constant area here, here. G and T both will be constant, G and T. And here only the difference between DAB and DBA. Okay, and here this thing you have already proved that this is the negative value of del PA by del X is equal to minus del P del DPB by DX. Okay, then this will be also equal. Then what you will get, you will find that DAB is equal to DBA. This particular term you have proved. Okay, means you are claiming after a particular time, after some time, the diffusion from A to B or B to A, both will be equal. Okay, have you got my point? Okay, and this kind of diffusion term you can easily find in your bioprocess engineering, bioreactors. One example I have shown, like whenever you will sparge any kind of oxygen, okay, into your reaction medium, to make your solution rich in oxygen, what you then what you have to do, similar kind of pattern you will find that how the will take place. Similarly, we have discussed about gas liquid, correct? Gas liquid, and this kind of pattern like liquid that can also occur. Liquid, if you will take the two immiscible liquid and you want to flow one liquid to the another liquid and both have the different physico chemical property, then this tan pattern can be occur. Okay, but problem is here you are looking for P and here you have to look for that C, but both are interrelated. Okay, you can convert from P to C and C to P, no problem. Okay, and this kind of pattern also you can find in your liquid solid interaction. Liquid solid, why I'm talking about liquid solid, because your cell, your that microorganism or your any kind of coli kind of thing, what you will see that here this is like a solid structure. Definitely it is semi permeable membrane, but definitely it have the solid kind of structure. Okay, when it will grow into the liquid system, into this is your liquid system, what you will find after some time, concentration of that haziness, or you can say the word turbidity, will increase. Turbidity, what does that mean? Means due to the turbid nature of your that the liquid, the OD will be higher whenever you will perform your experiment in UV. Okay, UV, this is the name of your equipment. Whenever you want to determine how much is the concentration of your that liquid system, you will find when the growth of the cell will increase, that the OD, the concentration, which will also increase. Okay, this thing comes here in the term of your counter and co as well. Both are similar, but mechanism both are same. Diffusion will occur from gas to liquid, or liquid to gas, or liquid to one liquid to another liquid, or solid to liquid. It can occur. Okay. This is your final expression that you have proved. Whenever it will be in equilibrium, you will get the same diffusivity. Let me read that they have mentioned. It follows that the equimolar diffusion, the diffusion coefficient DAB for the diffusion of gas component A into the gas component B is equal to the diffusion coefficient of DBA for gas component B into A. Okay, he's talking about two type of gases, one to A, then he's dealing with P. Okay, I think you have got. And for further calculation, they have derived like that for if you have the any kind of mole fraction of if you have mole fraction or you have different kind of boundary condition, you have to do nothing, you have to just integrate. You will get to know how much is the value of Na, how much is the value of the Nb. Okay, now steady state unidirectional. Okay, unidirectional diffusion, now we will see. Okay, before showing or before discussing, can someone tell how much will be the profile, how it will be look like? Can someone tell how it will be look like equimolar diffusion? I will discuss in the heat transfer. I'm repeating because these things are interrelated. If you will read heat transfer very thoroughly, then mass transfer is nothing for you. Now, we will talk about only, first of all, we will talk about the profile. Okay, we have seen this kind of profile and this kind of profile. Equimolar, okay, this is your counter. Now we are looking for unidirectional. Unidirectional means the diffusion will occur in the same direction, then profile will be like this only. This thing we have read in your heat transfer. Let me share your text. Where we have read this thing, this is critical thickness. Yes, now you can see. Let me make it bigger. Now, this is called as parallel flow, or you can say the co-current flow. when the fluid which is entering hot and cold at the same direction. Now you can see here you are getting this kind of pattern. Okay, this thing we have discussed, and we have also discussed what is the definition of LMTD, log mean temperature difference. LMTD, okay, this thing we have discussed. Okay, now you can see the difference here. The difference, it is very higher, and here the difference, it is very large, very small. So we are determining, we are quantifying LMTD. Based on that, we are calculating how much is the difference between both two segments, okay, from here to here. Now similarly, we have determined for counter current as well, and here we have also seen that the difference between two flow, it is uniform. This thing we have discussed, correct? Little bit uniform, not completely, but it is little bit. If you are saying, if it is difference from here to here, it is 50, so it is plus minus 5%. I am telling plus minus 5, 55 or 45. Okay, but in the case of co-current, or you can say the parallel flow, the difference, it is very high. Now you can see from here to here, and each and every position it is changing. If you draw the line, then you find the difference from here to here, it is changing each and every time. Similar pattern we will see here for mass transfer as well. Now you can see here, you see, if you have two gases, now you can see here you are injecting your air and water vapor, two gases. Now you can see here the difference, it is very high, and here difference, here difference, it is very small, and here difference is very high. Same kind of pattern. Now it is similar to your heat transfer. And here we have discussed about LMTD, log mean temperature difference, and here we will talk about log mean LMTD, temperature difference. Log mean temperature difference we have read in heat transfer. I am writing here HT, heat transfer. And what you will get here, L log mean partial pressure difference, PD, or you can say PP, partial difference. Okay, it will be occur in mass transfer. Okay, have you got my point, yes or no? Okay, the pattern, because anyway you want to determine that how much is the difference, then only you would be able to calculate your the difference delta P, or you can say the how much is the change from PA to PW or PA to PW. Okay, if it is your entrance, if it is your exit, now you can see the how much it is the variation, and you want to determine. So here in the heat transfer we have discussed about LMTD, and here we are discussing about LMPA. Formula, both are, everything is same. Okay, now we will see little bit derivation, how we can approach, how we can determine. Okay, now you have seen that profile. What you have to do, you have to apply the same formula. Now this thing, same formula, MA diffusivity A. Why it is A? Because you have multiplied by A here, MA divided by GT divided by del P by del X. Okay, del P by del X is equal to the partial pressure gradient of the air. Okay, now you have to determine bulk mass transfer of air upward direction. What you have to do, it will be this formula, like your density, this is your area, and this is your velocity. Okay, now he has mentioned the bulk up, that the bulk velocity in upward direction. Okay, it is velocity. Okay, then you have to convert same thing, density in this molecular form. Okay, after that you have to compare this particular term with this particular term, upward and downward. Okay, you will get this much will be the velocity, total mass, this much will be your velocity. Okay, then we have to determine First, you have to apply your mass balance. Okay, what you will do? The total mass transport of water vapor, it will be the sum of how much it is diffusion it is occurring when the water it is moving in the upward direction, plus water vapor carried out with the bulk movement of the air. Okay, then you have to add both terms. Okay, this will be your total mass transport. Whenever you will add, you have to rearrange, because this is the formula you have to put, you have to rearrange. After rearrangement, you will get this much amount of the total total mass of your water. Okay, same thing again, you have to apply, because you want to determine this particular term, you have to apply the Dalton's law. Same thing, P total pressure will be the sum of your partial pressure of air and water. Take the differentiation, assume this particular term as a zero, you will get this particular expression. Okay, whenever you will put all the term, you will get this final expression. Okay, and one more thing here, derivation it is not required for you, because derivation it is okay. We are looking for how the LMTD and LMPD it is interrelated, because both are related to each other, heat transfer and mass transfer. Okay, after that what you have to do, you have to just integrate, because you have to vanish this particular term. You have to integrate, you have to apply the boundary condition. After applying all the things, you will get this particular term. When you will compare, with LMTD, you have got the same kind of formula. You see, the formula for LMTD was theta, I'm writing theta m. Theta m is equal to T2 minus T1 divided by ln T2 by T1. This is T1, okay? This formula we have got for LMTD. And here you have got the same formula for log mean partial pressure difference. Same method, same approach, everything is same. Okay. And we have also seen this thing, okay, now in the arithmetic mean partial pressure difference, but we have also discussed that arithmetic mean have a lot of means arithmetic mean there will be a lot of error, you can say, because if your pattern it is like that. Okay, if you will take the arithmetic mean from this particular, how much is the difference, and this particular, how much is the difference, but it cannot give the correct value of how much is the mean partial pressure difference or mean temperature difference. Okay, so better to apply LMTD, log mean temperature difference, because this particular term or this particular curve, they are not a linear kind of curve. Sorry, they are little bit curve in nature. So if you will apply LMTD, it will give little bit accurate result as compared to your arithmetic mean. Okay, arithmetic mean. Okay, I think you have got little bit similarity. Heat transfer, we have got the same thing. We have also studied flow and counter. Here we also discuss about like cross flow, how the cross flow will occur, how the diffusion will occur, all the thing we have discussed in heat transfer. Similarly, we have today also discussed about how the LMTD is related to with LMP, like partial pressure, how it will behave, and how the counter and co current flow, if you are talking about the counter and co, how it will relate. Okay, this thing we have discussed. Okay, now the steady state diffusion in liquid, we have discussed about that, how the diffusion will take place in gases when one gas will diffuse from one point to the other point in presence of some other kind of gases. Now we will talk about the diffusion in liquid. Okay, just keep in your mind, whenever you are dealing with gases, then you have to write the term P, because you are talking about the partial pressure. Whenever you are discussing about gas, diffusion in gases, you have to use P term. P, it will be your partial pressure. When you are talking about liquid, then you have to discuss about the concentration difference. As we already seen in first class of the mass transfer, we have read that chemical potential difference is the driving force for mass transfer. Okay, just keep this word in your mind. Here we are talking about, we will talk about in term of partial pressure, and for the liquid we will discuss about in term of concentration gradient, or you can say the concentration difference. Okay. Now, steady state diffusion in liquid. Okay, steady state equimolar counter diffusion in liquid. Now you can see the molar flux of component A. This is your molar flux formula. We already know that JA is equal to minus DAB, or D you can write del CA by del X. Okay, this is the formula for, you can say, the fixed law of the diffusion. Okay, what they have did, they have opened, if you have two gradient like this is your chamber, one compound A here, diffusion will occur from this direction to this direction. He is writing CA minus CA2. If the A compound will diffuse from this particular position to this, CA minus CA2 divided by how much is the distance from this particular position to this particular position. And this thing we have already seen in Fick's law also. Okay, how you will determine why we are writing in term of X and how the position it is coming, because whenever you will apply any kind of gases into your reactor gas, it will travel some distance, or it will fill the deficit position of the oxygen to travel at this particular location. Okay, because it will be the oxygen rich, this bubble, it will travel where the deficiency of oxygen will be there. Okay, just keep in your mind. Okay, now okay, molar concentration they have given at x1 and x2, and here they have written like x is the distance, as I already told, how means from where to where it is changing. Okay, distance. Okay, these thing the unit conversion, this is nothing, this is just like a unit conversion. Okay, now first now the next we will talk about that unidirectional sorry, how it will change. Same, you have to apply the same formula, and for the unidirectional same term will come, because in unidirectional the difference will be very high, so you have to use log mean partial pressure, like this particular distance will be very high in the case of equimolar. Okay, for the liquid, here I am talking about the liquid. Now you can see the formula they have applied, LMPA, partial pressure difference. You have to do the same thing, same derivation we have shown above, but you have, don't worry about the derivation, just keep in your mind that how the pattern will be, like if somebody is saying equimolar or equimolar counter diffusion, or someone is saying unidirectional, then how your profile will be look like. Okay, and one more thing, for this kind of transfer, heat transfer or mass transfer, whatever, you have to keep in your mind that the difference you are looking for, that the difference, this difference, this you are interested to determine this particular difference. So how we are approaching, we are applying LMTD for liquid, LMTD for heat transfer, and LM log mean partial pressure difference for your mass transfer. Okay, don't worry about this derivation and all. Okay, this is for your understanding. Okay, so I have finished up to here, and I have one more class, I think, so I'm not pretty much sure, but maybe at 12 there will be one more class, so we will discuss about there the transient mass transfer. And one more thing, let me give brief introduction of that thing. In the mass transfer, we have, in the heat transfer for the transient, we have discussed about Biot number. Yaad hai ki nahi? Please tell. We have discussed about Biot number. Anyone knows Biot number? What is that Biot number? Biot number, it is formula HL by K. Okay, when somebody is asking what is the significance of Biot number, just tell him that it is the ratio of internal conduction resistance to the external conduction resistance. Okay, let me repeat. It is the ratio of internal conduction resistance to the external convection resistance. Okay, this thing we have discussed. This is conduction, okay, CD. This is conduction by convection resistance. And we have also seen that Biot number, there is the three kind of condition is there, Biot number, okay, Biot number. Biot number can be equal to 1. We have discussed this thing. Biot number less than 1, Biot number greater than 1. And for the lumped system, we are interested only in Biot number less than 1. Okay, Biot number less than 1 means this particular term will be less than convection term. Okay, we have also seen one picture, like if you will dip any kind of your iron ball, okay, iron, copper ball, any kind of ball into your liquid, okay, into your liquid system. This is your iron ball or copper ball, whatever, any kind of ball. Here will be two kind of resistance. We have discussed two kind of resistance. One, when the heat transfer will occur from inside to the outward direction, here will be your conduction, and around the surface here will be your convection resistance. We are looking for Biot number. Biot number signify whenever you will put any kind of solid surface, or you can say any kind of ball, into your liquid to determine the heat transfer, to calculate the heat transfer, then you have to read about the Biot number. And Biot number discuss about the resistance, how the resistance it is happening around the surface. And we have also seen one more thing, that the temperature gradient, or you can say the temperature difference, it is not a function of X, Y, and Z. We have read this thing, very good, very fundamental theory, Baba. It is not a function of X, Y, Z. So it is the function of time only. Okay. Temperature, it is the function of only time, T, function of T. Okay. And here we have also proved that how you will claim this thing. To claim this particular point, what we did, we have taken one ball here. We are assuming that at the time is equal to zero, time zero, here the temperature it is T naught. Each and every point here, each and everywhere, here will be temperature will be T naught. But after some time, T is equal to 20 minute, here will be temperature will be T1. Each and everywhere will be temperature T1. This is called as the lumped system, or you can say the transition system. Okay, transient condition. Okay, have you seen that this ball have the uniform temperature inside your body, and here the temperature after 20 minutes, because you are claiming T is not a function of X, Y, and Z. This thing you have read in heat transfer. And here you have also seen that T is the function of temperature only, time. So how you will correlate? At a particular time, T is equal to zero, you are claiming each and everywhere inside the body, temperature will be T naught. But after some time, the temperature will be Ti. This is called as the Biot number. This is called as the transient heat transfer, whatever you can say. Okay. This is also called as the lumped system. Just keep in your mind. Okay. And there is a small request, please. I have circulated whole notes for your heat transfer, mass transfer, and fluid mechanics. Please give half an hour or 1 hour, whatever you want to give. Please read once and discuss, or read fundamental theories only. And discuss with your friend each other, na, ki, arey, kya padha, kya nahi padha. Just read once and discuss, then you would be able to understand what is the beauty of this heat transfer, mass transfer. Because in bioprocessing one, sorry, bioprocessing two, there is one book, Duron, I forget exactly the pronunciation, but it is totally related to that heat, mass and mass, heat, fluid and mass. I will discuss in your last 2 to 3 lecture how it is related to your biomedical or bio application. Means you are doing your experiment in your flask, that is okay, means 10 ml, 5 ml, that is okay. But whenever you are talking about a scale up, or you want to scale up any kind of bioreactor from beaker to 100 liter of bioreactor, then you have to tune the parameter based on your experience. Not the fundamental thing, based on your experience, just keep in your mind. When you know each and every fundamental theory, then you would be able to solve this problem. Otherwise, you are nothing. Because whenever you will scale the parameter, if in the flask you are getting 50 degree temperature is optimum, when you will run for the 1000 liter, you will find no, it is not, the result it is not coming. Means you are expecting 100% conversion or 80% conversion, it cannot give the 100% conversion. So there is a lot of non-ideal things are happening. So it is based on your experience. Okay, whenever you will design, let me give little bit 1 minute or 2 minutes. Now generally people, what they are saying, this is your CSTR, call as ideal reactor in chemical engineering, in your bioreaction engineering, in your bioreactor design. Okay, this is called as the ideal reactor. This is your reactor, this is your agitator, that's it. But this is wrong. Ideally it is okay, this is mixture, means the mix, that the mixture of your reactant each and everywhere will be same, here each and everywhere will be same, but this is completely wrong. When you will deal with non-ideal reactor, means real scale application problem, then you will find there is a lot of stagnant point. This particular point, this here stagnant point will be there, this particular position stagnant point will be there. And here it can be, if it is rotating in this direction, it can create that around the surface stagnant point. So whenever you will design any kind of reactor, or you want to do some fermenter reactor, any kind of fermenter reactor, then you have to keep in mind that what will be the position of your agitator, and what and how the mass transfer you can increase. That is the biggest challenge as well in your fermenter. If you are providing continuous sparging and continuous stirring, so there is a lot of variable, not pH, not temperature, there is a lot of physical parameter as well. So there is a lot of that non-ideal condition. If you have experience of the ideal condition, then you would be able to understand how you can tune your parameter, how you can enhance, how you can increase your production yield. Okay, just keep in your mind. When you will do your experiment in your near future, then you will find, ha, Kuldeep to sahi bol raha tha, there is some kind of problem. Because in the beaker, that is okay, 5 liter you can get 100% result, that is okay. Everyone is getting 100% or 200%. But when you will deal with 100 liter or 200 liter, then you will find, kare, there is a lot of deviation from actual to your that non-ideal condition. Okay. Okay, there is a small suggestion, just read once heat and mass transfer, just revise once, and 2 to 3 things that is interrelated, like your fundamental theories, heat, mass, fluid, both are equal. Then your concept like counter current, co-current, each and everywhere it is equal. Okay, and your dimensionless parameter, we have read here, what we have read, like Biot number, we have read the Mach number in the fluid mechanics. We have read the Prandtl number, we have read the Fraud number, Reynolds number. Okay, here we have also get the Searwood number. Okay, we will get Schmidt number, all the number it will come in your mass transfer term. Okay, okay, then on the next class we will discuss, but first please read once, heat, mass and that fluid mechanics, please read once. Okay, if anyone have any query, he can ask.